Hello everyone, thanks for listening to this SAS Global Forum 2020 Super Demo. I'm Zohreh Asgharzadeh, and in this demo, I'm going to show how we monitor bee activity at SAS beehives using IoT and computer vision. So let's first review the motivation behind this work. One out of every three bites of food depends on bee pollination, most often honeybees. By 2050, we need to produce 70% more food to feed the growing world population. As a matter of fact, ensuring world food security will be impossible without honeybees. On the other hand, the death rate of bees in the US have been on the rise. Last year, we hit a new record. We lost more than 40% of our beehives. So beekeepers need to inspect hives more frequently. And a lot can happen between two inspections, like death of a queen. So any non-invasive tool that can help beekeepers learn about possible problems in the hive can be useful. So we have a very important problem to tackle, which is saving bees. We have some beehives on SAS's campus, and we have the power of analytics to study these hives. Nothing can stop us. So as a result, a team of bee enthusiasts were formed to study SAS's beehives. What we focus in this demo is the computer vision aspect of this project. The amount of light activity from hives can tell us a lot about foraging activity, since bees that are exiting and returning to the hives are typically foraging for nectar, pollen, and water. A lot of light activity implies the hive is healthy. By monitoring bees in flight, we are also able to notice and notify the beekeepers about swarms. Swarms indicate the hives are healthy and they're reproducing. One way to monitor the flight activities of the bees are through monitoring the count of the bees. But bees are tiny and they fly fast. Well, we have SAS event stream processing and SAS streaming analytics tools to overcome this problem. And the great news is, no labeling is required. So we do this through unsupervised learning processes. Now let's review the process flow for monitoring the count of bees entering and exiting a hive. The input to this process is the streaming image frames from a fixed camera at the hive. This process has two phases. In the first phase, we use SAS VIA to train an RPCA model, which is used for separating the foreground, which is flying bees, from the background. To do so, first, we crop the images to limit the area around the hive that we want to study. Next, we resize the images to the manageable size. Then, we flatten the images and feed it to the RPCA model. We store the ASTOR file generated from this RPCA model and use it in the next phase. In the second phase, we process the streaming frames using SAS event stream processing. On each frame, we follow the same pre-processing steps as before. Using the ASTOR generated in the previous phase, we extract the foreground of flying bees from each frame. Then, we use connected component analysis to locate the bees on each foreground image. Finally, we use ESP object tracker and accounting logic to count the incoming and exiting bees. So now I'm going to open a Jupyter notebook to walk you through the phase 1 steps in SAS VIA to pre-process the images and train an RPCA model. And at the end, I will briefly show an ESP dashboard for counting the incoming and exiting bees. But you will get a full demo of the ESP part in Tech Connect and other SGF demos. Okay, so let's go through first initial settings. So we import the SWAT package in Python to have access to CAS action sets and also some other Python libraries. And then we connect to CAS server, we provide the server name, the port, the username, and whatever else that's required to develop a connection. And we need three action sets in this demo: the robust PCI action set, image action set, and ASTOR action set. So this is the video that that's actually being streamed, and we are going to use this in this demo as an input. So you saw this video before in the previous slide, I'm going to play it one more time to just show you a point that if you track this bee on the top, and then if I go play the video a little bit back, and then you can see that if I stop the video and if you have a frame, it's hard to visually detect this bee. And fortunately for training our RPC model, we don't need any label data. So it's a totally unsupervised method. So that's one of the advantages of RPC, that we don't need anybody to manually label these images for the bees. Okay, so let's go back. And what we are feeding to this process is basically frames that are coming from the camera located at the fixed location next to the hive. So first we have to load the images. So we define a cast library first and point it to our images, location of our images in this path. And then we load the images, our training images, to this library. In this demo, we used the first 500 frames from the video to train the RPC model. And then we have to do some processing on the images, as I explained before. So the original dimension of the frames are 720 by 1280. So by cropping, we bring down the dimension to 440 by 1280. So we reduce the dimension on the x-axis because we don't need the whole frame for processing. We just need a part of frame. So we use the process image action from the image action set. And we use the function type getPatch and specify these dimensions. So if you look at the results, our cropped images would look something like this. And if you compare it with the original frames, you can see that the cropped area is the mid area somehow, so that we can count the number of flying bees towards the hive and out of the hive. So after the cropping step, we do convert the images to grayscale because we don't need the basically extra input for color images to the RPC, and grayscale images would work just as fine, and also it brings down the computational effort. Especially this is important for ESP because ESP has to process the images on the fly. So we use the again the process image action. We use the this time we use the function type convert color, and we convert it to grayscale color to gray. So this is the result of the converting the images to grayscale. And next, we resize the images. We don't need to work with the high resolution images again for the purpose of the computational effort. We bring down the dimension from both dimension X and dimension Y to half, so from 440 to 220 and from 1280 to 640. And we use this using the resize function type in the process image action. Next, we have to feed these images to an RPCA model as a table. So the rows of these tables represent the images. So each row is associated with one frame, and the columns are the pixels in each frame. And so to do that, we need to use the action that's called flatten image. So this is a syntax for flatten image, and we feed the images to this flatten image table, and we provide the widths and heights of the images, and it basically converts them to that table. Next, we feed that table to an RPC model. So I take the opportunity to briefly introduce the RPCA model. So in the nutshell, RPCA model decomposes an input table into a low rank table and sparse table through an optimization. So in our case, the input table would be images, and the low rank table would be the background, and the sparse table would be the foreground of flying bees. So we fit the flattened table, flattened image images to the RPC model, and we did some tuning and set one of the parameters of the RPC model, which is the most important parameter, lando weight, to 1.1. It's basically, lando weight is a coefficient that balances how much sparse we want the sparse matrix to be and how low rank the low rank matrix we want it to be. And then we save the results into a save state file or a store file, and we call it store. Next, we need to download this ASTore file so that ESP can use it. And we do this through the download action of the ASTore action set. And we put it somewhere so that the ESP can grab this binary blob file to do the scoring of the images. So now I'm going to demo you in SAS via the result of the scoring of these images, and then later on I'm going to show you the ESP dashboard. So we have to do the same process on the on all the image frames in this step. So we had about 2400 images in that original video that you see. We did train on the first 500 images, and now we score on all images, and you can see that we have to do the same pre-processing steps for scoring images as well. And then we do the scoring through the call to the score function of the ASTore action set. And we store the results. But to be able to visually see the results, we have to condense the images, which is basically doing the reverse processing that we did on the images. And also we need to save the images. So this is basically the foreground of the flying bees from that original video. Now, as you can see, the background is all removed, and when we have images like this, the object tracker can easily track the bees and then do the final counting. So here is a recording of the ESP dashboard. I thought that to briefly show you this dashboard. On the right, you can see that the foreground of flying bees is displayed, and in the middle, you can see bees are detected and object tracker tracks their movement, and they label them as incoming bees or departing bees, arrivals and departures. On the right, you can see the counts of the arrivals and departures of the bees over a pre-specified period of time. I guess in this case, it's 3 seconds. And here the frames are fed to the ESP system at the rate of 10 images per second. At the end, I would like to mention that there are other aspects to this project, like analyzing the acoustic data from the hives that you might have already heard or read about in this SGF. Also, I would like to thank so many collaborators of this project, and special thanks to Anya McGurig and Brad Klenz for helping with this super demo. I hope this presentation motivated you to plant more flowers, trees, or shrubs to provide bees with pollen and nectar. Thanks for watching.